Did you know that the snowpack is the amount of snow that has fallen to the ground but hasn't melted yet? This year, the snowpack in Utah is the highest that it has ever been.
UCA, UCA, Utah Connection Academy.
Welcome back to another episode of UCA News. I'm Mika.
I'm Sarah Beth. Today is April 31st, and this is episode 28.
Did you know that there will only be four more episodes of UCA News this year?
Only four? Wow. The end of the school year is going to be here before we know it.
The last month of school is going to fly by. Not only will our students be working to finish their classes, achieve higher grades, but we also have several awesome field trips and events coming up.
That's right. We have prom coming up, a stargazing field trip, graduation, and the annual talent show, all taking place in May. And that's not even everything.
That's why you should make sure you watch UCA News every week so that you are always up to date on everything happening here at Utah Connections Academy.
But we don't just deliver high quality news on a weekly basis. We also provide some entertainment. Let's send it out to Max with our joke of the week.
Right.
Why was the live lesson room glitching? Because it was.
You gotta love technology struggles. We have all been there. Are you there?
Sorry, I think I was glitching. You know what else is exciting?
What?
We are officially done with state testing.
We are. It's over. We deserve a 15-second dance party.
So get up out of your chair, putting your dance shoes on, and join us for 15-second dancing.
My village, my pride, my Beatles, my Jackson 5. My reason, my rhyme, my ready anytime. Yeah, everything is alright. When we come together, come together, my people, my tribe. When we
Let's move on to our next segment. Throughout this year, our Arub has been reporting on different colleges around the state. She is back with another interesting edition on College Corner. Take it away, Arub.
Hello, and welcome back to another segment of College Corner with Arub, where I cover continuing education and colleges in our state. This week, I will be doing something different. Instead of picking a specific college like in previous segments, I will be covering an alternative to the traditional college experience, technical and trade schools. In this segment, I will cover what exactly technical and trade schools are, what programs they offer, and what schools are located in Utah. First, I'll talk a little about what technical and trade schools are. They can be known as vocational schools as well. These terms are used generally and are pretty loose. It can depend on the specific school. They are basically educational institutions that provide technical and career-focused training for students who want to develop specific skills and knowledge in a particular trade or industry. Technical and trade schools often have shorter programs than traditional universities, allowing students to complete their education and join the workforce more quickly. While program length varies at different schools, most students can graduate within 2 years or less. These schools can be a great choice for those who want to gain practical skills and knowledge in a specific field without having to take general education courses. These programs typically provide hands-on training and practical experience, allowing students to develop the technical skills and knowledge necessary to succeed in their chosen field. There are a variety of programs, such as dental assisting, construction, electrical trades, electrician apprentice, construction, medical assisting, cosmetology, being a nail technician, culinary arts, non-destructive inspection, being a nursing assistant, real estate, software technology and development, web and graphic design, barbering, business, and computer-aided design. And here are a few Utah technical colleges and trade schools. Ogden Weber Technical College, Fortis College, Dixie Technical College, Bridgerland Technical College, Uinta Basin Technical College, Granite Technical Institute, and Mountainland Technical College. If you are interested in learning job-specific skills, then this pathway might be the right one for you. That is all I will be covering this week. Thank you for tuning in this week to College Corner, and I hope to see you all next time.
That was incredible. I'm not quite ready to start my college journey, but thanks to Rube, I have some great information when I am ready.
I think we could all use a little motivation, whether you need some motivation as you are finishing the year strong, starting college, or just getting through a Monday. We've got you covered. It's time for a quote of the week.
Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts.
I love that quote.
I did as well. With just over a month left in the school year, we thought it would be a good time to share some tips on finishing the year strong.
Max here. I've been a student at UCA for the last 8 years. I'd like to share some tips for success at the end of the year. Check your grades regularly. Go to an out. Don't procrastinate. Don't give up. Your teachers and learning coaches are always here to support you.
Those were great tips. I know I need to listen to the one about not procrastinating, but hey, that's next week me problems.
One of our amazing staff members was recently named a Connections Academy Rockstar. This person was one of the 5 winners from across the country. Let's find out about Teresa Beauregard.
Teresa moves through life with integrity. It's integrity that drives her inclusivity and respect for all people at all times. Teresa was actually the first person I met at UCA. She was so nice. Her kindness in those initial moments took some of my nerves away. Before my interview, she was the first person I met when applying to teach at UCA. After meeting her, I knew that this was somewhere I wanted to be. She plays such a huge role in our school climate.
Teresa feeds off of collaboration, always making herself approachable even when she is juggling many things at once. When you are meeting with Teresa, she makes you feel like you are her only priority. Teresa is an amazing woman to work alongside at UCA. She is the person behind the scenes who ensures everything runs smoothly. Our school is such a great place to work and for students to attend because of Teresa. She is organized, detail-oriented, and has great communication and interpersonal skills.
We're almost out of time, but first, is this right? Joke of the week?
That's right. This joke was created by our very own Siani, and you're going to love it.
What do you call a plant that can cook? Garden Ramsay.
I love that joke. Well, folks, that is all we have for today. Thank you again for checking out each episode.
We love making UCA news, and we hope that you enjoy watching them. We will see you next week because we're
UCA.